A lot of people who are talking about Prop 37 are acting as if this is a simple thing, right? Why would people object? How hard is it to label? I saw one person write, how much does that ink cost? And the problem is, very few people have much of an idea of how the grain commodity system works in the United States or in the rest of the world. You really have to think of it more in the analogy of a river. If the rain falls on hillsides in various places, runs down the hills into small streams, and those collect into larger streams that eventually go into rivers, that's sort of the image of what happens with grain. And once you're into the river, or even into the small stream, the question of, well, where did that drop of water came from is you know, impossible to answer. And that's essentially the same thing that happens in the commodity system. The way that the grain system works is very much like that river. You've got thousands of individual farmers, most of whom have many different fields that are planted to different varieties. There's shared equipment that is used. It's more efficient to bring combines up at the United States as the season ends, so the same combines are harvesting many different fields, grain wagons. These things go into trucks maybe that go to a local grain elevator, and then from there they can go into 110 train cars or barges. And sort of all original identity, say, well, was this a GMO corn or wasn't this a GMO corn? It's just not something you can really answer. And so to keep something separate actually requires sort of a completely independent grain handling system. And that can be done, but that comes with a cost, because every truck that isn't completely filled, every silo that isn't completely filled, and just dedicated equipment all along the way. So keeping things separate is actually fairly costly. And considering that for most of the grain crops we're talking about, it's a lot more practical to just label the very small amount that somebody has gone to all that work to keep separate, rather than to try to be doing some sort of tracking over the entire system. And those labels already exist. People are allowed to make those claims of non-GMO, even though there's no safety reason, but they can do that. And so that's a lot more logical way to do it than trying to get one state to tell an entire country how to change their grain handling system.